Yes, I chose the JX Pro over the Commandante C40. Let me tell you why. I remember a few months back when I was searching for a manual espresso grinder, most of the conversations online would direct you to buy the Commandante as the end game grinder. I was quite surprised to realize na yung price pala niya is 15,000 pesos. So my pocket told me to look for alternative options or secondhand the Commandante grinder, but unfortunately during that time, no one was selling. So today, I'll be sharing about how I made the decision to buy the JX Pro, and we won't be talking about uniformity of the grind size, impact to taste. There are other videos out there from Hoffman or the Coffee Chronicler who have covered these topics much more extensively. So this video is really for those who are at the point of deciding between the JX Pro or the Commandante or any other high-end grinders out there. I'm a beginner myself and I'm just really here to share kung ano yung nage-experience ko in making a decision that might be helpful for you before you make that purchase. I've been using this for more than 6 months and I could easily say that I do not have any regrets since a purchase decision ko. Can it pull great espresso shot? Is it easy to clean? Is it built to last? My answer to all three is a yes. I honestly still love the design of the Commandante if we're going to focus on aesthetics. Para na rin siyang luxury item the way I see it, but I still ended up with the JX Pro. This is no longer surprising, but the number one reason for me is value for money. Yung Commandante is 15,000 pesos, JX Pro is 7,500 pesos, mapapaisip ka talaga. Of course, there's no doubt that Commandante is a great grinder, but for my purpose, kailangan ko pa bumili ng Red Clicks, which will allow me to expand yung grind settings ng Commandante. And that will set me back for another 2,500 pesos. So all in all, that 17,500 in comparison sa JX Pro, which is only 7,500 pesos. Number two naman is that it's a grinder designed for espresso. So off the box, you can use the JX Pro from Turkish, which is super fine, to espresso, AeroPress pour over, and even French press. It has 200 settings readily available within 5 revolutions, which means na in the espresso game, yung micro adjustments na yun will allow you to dial in your beans much more easily. The burr size of the JX Pro is larger at 48 millimeters in comparison to the Commandante, which is at 39 millimeters. So from my experience, I normally take around 45 seconds, probably to 60 seconds at the most if mag-grind ako ng 20 grams of beans. In comparison to the Commandante, which will take around a minute to a minute and 20 seconds. Third reason naman is ease of use and build. Adjustments can easily be done on top of the grinder. So after removing yung handle, you have your numbers over here. So a few clicks, depending on your preference, you can easily adjust based on the kind of coffee that you will be brewing. In comparison to the Commandante, where kailangan mo pang buksan yung bean hopper, kailangan mo tanggalin, and then you will fix yung settings or dial in at the bottom. So, yung workflow for me is a huge part, and I feel like yung JX Pro is a lot faster in that sense. Naging malaking consideration for me yung longevity ng product. Off the box, yung Commandante would come with a glass jar right at the bottom. In comparison here with the JX Pro, bean hopper niya is metal. So kanina nahulog to during our B-roll shoot and namaga pa yung floor. In their website, it also shows na before you need to replace yung burrs, it will take you around 100 kilograms to 200 kilograms of beans before you need to have it replaced. So that means, lagay na lang natin sa gitna, if 150 kilograms ng beans yung kailangan mong i-brew, that will take you around 7,500 cups of coffee before you need to have this replaced. If there's something naman na I wish available sa JX Pro, of course yung color options. If may gusto kang theme sa bahay na black, for example, hindi mo yun magagawa. And ito lang yung available na color. I noticed naman na may tendency na umangat yung rubber. Especially if nagkakaroon na siya ng coffee grounds, you'll need to adjust it manually and ibababa mo siya every time you use it. Another minor complaint is yung fact na medyo lumuluwag siya. And as you can hear, yan, naglulusan yung thread. So you need to be very careful while you're grinding. But that wouldn't stop me from buying a JX Pro. Do I see myself naman upgrading in the near future based from my experience using the JX Pro? My quick answer to that is no. Ang ginawa ko na lang from the money that I saved is bumili ako ng additional na grinder, which I will be mainly using when I'm traveling kasi mas maliit and it will easily fit dun sa AeroPress. That's it. Those are my top 3 reasons why I bought the JX Pro. So I hope these are all helpful, and comment down below. We'd love to hear your thoughts.